YouTube, my name is Mesa Sean, and welcome back to another Destiny 2 video. Alright folks, it's XUR’S Day, it's Friday, and he is located over on the European Dead Zone. You want to fly into Winding Cove, and you want to head on over to the cave that I'm about to go to right now. If you're new to Destiny 2, XUR comes to the solar system every Friday at reset, and then he will leave on Tuesday at reset, and you want to go to this little cave right here. So XUR, if you're new to Destiny 2 also, for the season has a new exotic engram, a new exotic dawn engram, which we'll get into in a second. So let's go see what XUR has. Okay, XUR has the Colony, a void grenade launcher, Raid Influx, excellent for the Hunter, Mask of the Quiet One for the Titan, and Crown of Tempest, excellent helmet for the Warlock. So this is this new engram for the season. Yes, it is new for just for this season. Don't worry, it'll stop being in the title next season. But if you're missing something, buy this on a character that you need something on. If you're missing any exotic in the game, aside from quest exotics, this thing can give it to you. If you have everything in the game in terms of exotics, aside from quest exotics, it will give you a random piece of armor. It will give you an exotic armor piece with a random roll in it. So if you got everything and you're looking to get a better roll on something, let's say you're a Hunter main and you want a better roll on your Shards of Galenor, buy it on your Hunter and you might get Shards of Galenor and get a good roll in it. All right, the Colony Grenade Launcher. This one is void. We have insectoid robot grenades. This weapon's grenades are insectoid robots that chase targets and explode close to them. We have linear compensator, high velocity rounds, and we have serve the colony. Insectoid robot grenades quickly repopulate the magazine from reserves while the colony is unequipped. So in other words, it's got cocoon on it from Destiny 1 or auto-loading holster. All right, Raid Influx. Buy this if you do not have it. This thing's amazing for the Hunter. So, quick successive attacks with Arc Staff increase its damage, output, and duration. As long as you're clearing adds with this thing, it will make your Arc Staff go on forever and ever and ever. Love this. Whenever I use Arc Strider, I definitely put this on. All right, Mask of the Quiet One. So, grants ability energy when you're damaged. When critically wounded, regain maximum health on kills. Pretty weird and kind of cool looking Titan helmet, but I gotta be frank, I never use it. Alright, Crown of Tempest. This is pretty much all I ever use with my Stormcaller. In fact, on my Warlock, if I'm using Top Tree, yeah, this thing's gonna make it go on forever because you combine this with Transcendence when cast with full grenade and melee energy. Storm Trance will last longer and fully restore your health, but the last longer, that's the critical part, because you combine that with Crown of Tempest, and let's look at the main perk again. Arc ability kills increase the recharge rate of your arc abilities, but it will extend the duration of Storm Trance. So you could just annihilate a whole bunch of enemies. It's kind of similar to Raid Influx and its arc as well, and that you just clear out adds, and this thing will last forever when you combine it with the Top Tree for the Stormcaller. So the rolls and energies on these things, they all come from your collection, so nothing random, but this will give you a random roll. All right, you have your Five of Swords card if you want to customize your old school Nightfall experience, and we have our Invitations of the Nine if you still have not completed those. I believe they give you a tier 1 powerful drop. All right, that's going to do it for this video, guys. Sorry if my voice sounds a little deep here. It's about that time of the year when I am sick, and yeah, I have a cold. And, man, looking at the comments last night, everyone's really ticked off. Check out my news video from last night with regards to all the stuff Bungie is nerfing. You know, good old Forcer, I'm going to give you a shout-out. You're in every single Destiny content creator's video's comment section. We all love you. He brought up a good point. You know, maybe they're nerfing grenade launchers and Izanagis and snipers because of the fact that maybe we're getting a new raid. But then also maybe the high-end PvE activity, I think he just put in raid, but then I'm thinking out loud, or I was in the channel member Discord last night, thinking out loud that perhaps the high-end PvE activity we're going to get for next season, and they haven't confirmed anything, they don't want us to just go in there with a sniper and, well, snipers and grenade launchers and just annihilate whatever boss or whatever it is that we need to kill at the end of it. Maybe that's their reasoning behind it. I don't know. I'm trying to figure out what their reasoning is, and right now I can't think of it. So I'm babbling because I need to go get myself some cold medicine. All right, guys, that's it. So leave me a hashtag made it to the end if you did make it to the end. And if you'd like to further support this channel and join an awesome Mesa Army Destiny 2 community over on Discord, click the link in the description or click join on screen. And also, we've got a Mesa Army clan for PC, Xbox, and PS4 if you need one as one of the many bonus perks. All right, that's it, guys. Drop a like on this video only if you see fit. Follow me on Twitter at MesaSean. Check out my stream. Usually, always on YouTube, and that's it. I am out of here like Vladimir.